What is up, guys? Richard C. Hibbard back again with another video, and this time I'll be reviewing the 1990 Disney animated feature The Rescuers Down Under, which is the second movie in the Disney Renaissance era from 1989 through 1999. I've never done movie reviews on my channel before, so this will be my first one. Now, before we get started, I have some things to say. When I was little, I remember watching the 1991 Black Diamond Classics VHS for this movie, which I only watched part of because I remember stopping at the restaurant scene when I watched this with my twin sister, falling asleep during that scene. I didn't watch the movie the whole way through until I watched the 2000 Gold Classic Collection VHS of the same movie in elementary school when I was in second grade, and that's how this movie traumatized me as an 8-year-old. The more I watched, the more traumatized I've became. Alright, let's get started on today's review, shall we? The film starts off with Cody being woke up by Falou's distress call, and he promises Mother that he'll be back home in time for supper. Then he runs through the forest, which is where the distress call was to take place in, and we meet Cody's animal's friends, including Falou, the kangaroo, who is the one sounding the call as she informs Cody that Merihuti, the gray golden eagle, has been captured by poachers, and Cody is the only one who can set her free. After Cody got up on top of the tall cliff, he meets Merihuti, who freaks out when she sees him, and right as Cody finished setting her free, Merihuti, while still freaking out, accidentally knocks Cody off the cliff, and she dives down the cliff to save Cody from hitting the ground. Boy, the part with Cody falling off the cliff freaked me out a little as a kid, but definitely not to the point where it gave me nightmares. I love the scene where Cody goes on a fun flying adventure with Merihuti, especially the water skiing sequence. They eventually land safely at the nest. After the flight, Cody builds a friendship with Merihuti and learns that she's going to be a mother soon while looking at the eagle eggs. And when he asks her where the daddy eagle is at, Merihuti sadly faces down, then Cody reveals that his father is gone too. But we don't know what happened to Cody's lost father, whether he was eaten by crocodiles or... who knows. That sad on look Merihuti tells that her mate was killed by poachers. Merihuti gives Cody a feather as a gift for freeing her, and then later, Merihuti brings Cody back to the lower grounds. As Cody was making his way back home to his mother's, he finds a mouse that's been tied up in a poacher's trap. Cody freed him, but he falls into the poacher's trap. Then we see a monstrous, highly destructive truck driven by a wanted local poacher named Percival C. McLeach, who's after the great golden eagle. Soon, McLeach finds the feather on the back of Cody's backpack, and he's instantly drawn to it. He later reveals to Cody that he's the one who killed Merihuti's mate.
That's no secret, boy. You see, I already got the father.
Murderer!
Murderer!
Then he evilly demands Cody to lead him to the eagle and her eggs. Cody tries to run away, but Joanna chases after him, and McLeach catches up and tosses Cody's backpack to the crocodiles as a way to trick the rangers into thinking he was devoured. Then he throws Cody into the large cage of his monstrous truck and drives him away. That's another part that made me uncomfortable as a kid. Soon, the message was sent to New York City, where the Rescue Aid Society was located in. The next scene, which is the restaurant scene, is the part I stopped at and fell asleep when I watched the 1991 VHS as a 2-year-old. We see the return of Bernard and Miss Bynanka as they were having their dinner date, and their dinner date was interrupted by the message from Australia, and they set off to find Orville, but instead, they find another albatross bird named Wilbur, who's Orville's brother. Bernard and Bynanka soon inform Wilbur about the kidnapped boy, and Wilbur flies them to Australia. Later, Cody's mother noticed that her son was missing, and so she called for him to come home, but no response came, and so she called the rangers to go out and look for her missing child. After Bernard, Bynanka, and Wilbur land in Australia, they meet Jake, an Aussie kangaroo mouse. But then Wilbur cracks his back and he was sent to the hospital before the mouse trio went on to search for Cody. Back in McLeach's lair, McLeach threatens Cody into revealing Marahute's location, at one point negotiating a 50-50 split between the money he would earn from her, but Cody refuses. This gets him thrown in a small cage inside a room with several of McLeach's captured animals. Cody and the animals attempt to get the keys to the door, but was prevented by Joanna, McLeach's loyal pet Goanna. Seeing Cody locked up in a cage was pretty sad and painful to watch as an 8-year-old. During the scenes with Bernard, Bianca, and Jake going on a search for Cody, Jake keeps talking to Bianca, which makes Bernard feel left out. And not only that, Bernard is getting ready to marry Bianca, but he kept failing to propose to her due to so many interruptions happening whenever he tries to make his attempt to do so. I kind of feel bad for Bernard in those scenes. Meanwhile, Wilbur escapes from the hospital and flies off to search for Bernard and Bianca, which he flies past above Cody's house, where a ranger was knocking on the front door, and after Cody's mother answers it, he gives her the devoured backpack, assuming her son was another victim of the crocodile attack, leaving her heartbroken. Back at McLeach's lair, McLeach overhears the radio man talking about the assumed news, and was pleased that his trick succeeded. Next, after McLeach gets his eggs out from his refrigerator, Joanna steals the eggs one by one, which is one of the funniest scenes in the entire film, despite it being dark. All of a sudden, McLeach comes up with an awful idea to trick Cody into leading him to the eagle's eggs. We return to Cody and the captured animals, and without even noticing, Frank unlocked himself out of the cage with his tail, but ends up being chased around by Joanna while Cody freed himself out of the cage before attempting to set all the other animals free, which their escape plan sadly failed when McLeach grabs Cody and takes him out of his hideout. The three heroic mice eventually made it to the hideout, and they spot McLeach kicking Cody out, and then McLeach lies to Cody about Marahute being shot by someone else, and tells him to get out, which Cody does so. Then McLeach follows him in his bushwhacker, and the mouse trio jump onto the half truck. Once they arrived, they warned Cody that he's in great danger, but Cody was distracted by Marahute's screeches, and it wasn't long before Marahute was recaptured by McLeach. And Cody, Bianca, and Jake were all captured too, while Bernard was left behind on the eagle's nest, where he manages to protect the eggs from Joanna, whom McLeach lowers to the nest to eat the said eggs by swapping them out with some smooth rocks. Wilbur then arrives at the nest, at which point Bernard convinces him to guard the eagle's eggs. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Behold, the scariest scene in the entire film, the crocodile bait scene. By God, this scene gave me nightmares as an 8-year-old when I watched it the whole way through. First, McLeach dangles Cody over a river full of monstrous crocodiles to murder him, which was prevented when Bernard turns off McLeach's half-truck. But to make the scene even more scary, McLeach grabs his shotgun and shoots at the rope holding Cody above the water, and he was about to finish his evil deed until Bernard tricks Joanna into ramming into McLeach, sending both the poacher and his vicious pet into the river. Eventually, the crocodiles switch their attentions from Cody as they swam towards McLeach as their new targeted bait. But things resume to being scary when the damaged rope holding Cody finally snaps, sending the poor boy into the river. Bernard saves Cody from drowning, but when Cody gasps for air, he and Bernard were both heading for a dangerous waterfall, which is the exact same waterfall McLeach falls over to his presumed death. By God, seeing Cody falling over the waterfall had me panicking in fear as a kid, and I thought Cody was going to die while he was heading for a deadly waterfall like that. But I was surprised and relieved that Marahute saved him from death, and I was adored by Bernard finally proposing to Bianca. But my mood soon changed regarding how the film ended, which made the film incomplete. After that day, I vowed myself to never watch that traumatizing movie ever again because of so many terrifying moments. And watching it as an adult, it was way darker than I remembered. However, the film still had some heartwarming moments that I enjoyed watching, and those heartwarming moments felt like we were building up to that moment where Cody reunites with his mother, but it sadly never happened in the film. I really appreciated that the film seemed to be embracing the power of maternal love, paralleling Marahuti's love for her eggs with the mother's love for Cody, but the ending didn't satisfy that feeling. Even Marahuti is not reunited with her eggs at the end, which I realized that a few months ago. Instead, we get a dumb scene between Wilbur and the hatched eggs, which made the ending rushed. Now don't get me wrong, I liked the movie, but honestly, you can't just have Cody say let's all go home and end the film right there. Did they really expect us to accept Cody's reunion with his mom happening off screen and imagine it ourselves? The poor woman was heartbroken when she was led to believe her son was dead. You can't just sweep something like that under the rug and never address it again. The same goes with all the other animals that were still trapped in McLeach's lair. And surely the heroes wouldn't just abandon them and not come back for them later after learning where the lair is. It doesn't help that they get excluded. And yet, like I mentioned earlier, Wilbur get his ending scene where he was left behind to guard Marahuti's babies and they hatch. It's like Disney's policy for did we forget something scenes that are only used when it's played for laughs, which is not funny at all. In the first Rescuers movie, we got to see Penny happily adopted by her new parents at the end, but why didn't we get to see Cody reunite with his mother in the sequel? You had one job, Disney! Another biggest issue I have with this movie is that the captured animals never escaped, because I was hoping Cody would get them all out before McLeach comes back, but it sadly failed when McLeach dragged Cody out of his lair and said this.
Say goodbye to your little friends. It's the last you'll ever see of them.
Honestly, that line hit us too, because it truly was the last we ever saw them in the film, which also made it incomplete. Then again, it raises the question of what happened to the imprisoned animals. All the characters seem to forget them, meaning they'll all slowly starve and dehydrate to death, unless Cody somehow found the hideout again or brought the rangers with him. Or worse, if Joanna, who appears to be a lace Goanna, remembered they were all there and went back to devour all the animals one by one. Also, if you look closely at McLeach while he's falling over the waterfall, you can see him tucking into a ball as he goes down. That's actually considered a fairly effective way to survive a waterfall, since the impact is minimized and you hit the water with less force and avoiding any rocks. I actually believed McLeach survived the waterfall, but it was also a way for McLeach to get away with his horrible crimes, which came off as unacceptable, and made matters worse, because McLeach would have been delighted while watching Cody falling over the waterfall to his near death. Perhaps McLeach will soon be knocking on Cody's door to get revenge on him, and the Rescue Aid Society won't be able to rescue him in time. I'm very disappointed with the film's incomplete ending after all the trauma Cody went through of being tormented and nearly murdered by a dangerous poacher, and after nearly falling to his death over the same waterfall McLeach fell over, which tells that McLeach's plan to kill Cody almost succeeded, as explained on the Nightmare Fuel page of this movie on TV Tropes, and I'm honestly surprised that Cody never cried in this movie. God, that poor boy needs some therapy. There's a reason I made my Cody's Nightmare video. I just felt like we never got to see true justice for Cody. As a kid, I hated McLeach so much that I wish he actually went to jail for kidnapping Cody. Also, the main villain never lays his eyes on the rescuers. Even though Percival C. McLeach is the main villain of the film, he never lays his eyes on Bernard, Miss Bynanka, or Jake, which is one of my issues with this film. To be fair, I guess Bernard wanted to avoid being seen by McLeach while doing what he can to rescue Cody from being fed to the crocodiles. The Rangers were not as brave as they should have been. The scene where the ranger gives Cody's mother her son's devoured backpack, leaving her to believe her son was eaten by the crocodiles, is by far the saddest scene in the entire film. And the same goes to the scene where she calls for her lost son to come home. It really bothers me of how the rangers never bothered to look for Cody in McLeach's lair, which was the only possible location where Cody is captured in. When the rangers called off the search for Cody, it shows that the rangers were not as brave like they should have been. I liked how Cody threatened to tell the rangers on McLeach, but I didn't like how the rangers never came face to face with McLeach, even though they hung a wanted poster of the ruthless poacher on one of the trees before Cody was even kidnapped, as shown from earlier in the film. Given that McLeach's truck leaves a trail anyone can follow, you'd think he'd be rather easier for the rangers to find him. But it started raining right after Cody was kidnapped, so the trail might have been washed away by the rain. If Disney fans paid closer attention to the cliffhanger in the film's ending, they probably would have sent nasty letters to Disney for not including the scene where Cody reunites with his mother. The cliffhanger ending is one of the reasons why I made my Cody's Nightmare video on my YouTube channel, and the same goes to the scenes where McLeach tortures and nearly kills Cody. The only way for this movie to be actually complete is by replacing the dumb Wilbur and the hatching egg scene with the scene where Cody reunites with his mother and where Mare Hootie reunites with her eggs, and she actually gets to watch them hatch. Anyways, once again, the film's ending was not pleasing at all because of its main focus. After our lovable child character went through so much despair at hands or actions of an extremely nasty character. Justice wasn't served, in my opinion. And there you have it, my Rescuers Down Under review. This film not only traumatized me as a kid, but it also has a bunch of things that bothers me about it, which I already got them all covered in this video. One last thing. Here's how I reacted to the film's ending as an 8-year-old.
That's not a happy ending, cried Percy.
Ah, murmured Thomas. There will be one, but that'll have to wait until next time.
So basically, this film is pretty decent in my opinion, so I give it a 6 out of 10. If it actually showed Cody reuniting with his mother, then I would have given this film a little higher rating. If you like this movie more than I do, which I know most of you do, then that's fine with me. I respect your opinion. Even so, I wish Disney made a third Rescuers movie, but not the Rescuers 3, Cody and Penny, which I find that idea overrated, because I don't want Cody and Penny to be kidnapped by their same old enemies again. If a third Rescuers movie was needed, then it needs to be more on the serious side instead of the adventure side. And McLeach will try to get his revenge in the sequel as well. So I'm currently working on my fanfic that takes place right after The Rescuers Down Under, and it's called Revenge of McLeach, which I actually wish it was a real Disney movie, and if it was real, then it would be released in 1993, the year no Disney animated classic were released on, unless if you want to count Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas, but that movie was distributed by Touchstone Pictures during that time. Well, that's all I had to say in this video, and I apologize if I ranted too hard on some of the scenes from this movie. See you all next time!